This is problem 46 in chapter 3 of Donnelly's second edition. I will show you how to compute correlation coefficient and covariance for this data set. We have five observations, five paired observations between x and y. We will be using these equations, equation 30, which is for covariance from your book, equation 31, which is for correlation coefficient, and we will use the standard deviation calculation sample, standard deviation equation. Notice that in the covariance calculation we need to have the average x and the average y values. So we need to compute the averages. In order to compute the average, we must have summation and then divide by the number of observations. Summation of x column is 25. Summation of y column is 30. Mean or average value for x and y, therefore, is 25 divided by 5, which is 5. And for y, it's 30 divided by 5, which is 6. Next step is to recognize that we need to compute the difference between each x value and its bar, and its mean, or x bar. So 4 minus 5, the average, 4 minus 5 is negative 1. 7 minus 5 is 2. 2 minus 5 is negative 3. 6 minus 5 is 1, and 6 minus 5 is 1. We do the same thing for y values, y minus y bar. So x y is equal to 4 minus 6 is negative 2. Next y value is 9. 9 minus 6 is 3. Similarly, 5 minus 6 is negative 1. 5 minus 6 is negative 1. And 7 minus 6 is 1. The next thing is we need to compute the product of or multiply each of these differences that we just found. So what we will do is say negative 1 times negative 2 is 2. 2 times 3 is 6. Negative 3 times negative 1 is 3. 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. And 1 times 1 is 1. Then notice the equation tells me that I need to sum them up. I need to add them up. So I found the product of these two columns in here. This is the product, and now I need to add it up. So the summation of this column is 11. Notice the covariance equation tells me that summation should be divided by n minus 1. We had 5, n was 5, or 5 sets of observations, so n minus 1 is, or 5 minus 1 is 4. So covariance between x and y, which is covariance, is equal to 11 divided by 4, which happens to be 2.75. In the next video, I will show you with Excel that the sample covariance in this data set is 2.75. So let me write that better. 2.75. Then we want to compute correlation coefficient. We designate the correlation coefficient. Sometimes it's called Pearson's product moment correlation coefficient, but we designate it with the letter R. So this is the correlation coefficient. Sample correlation coefficient is some is I'm sorry, it's the covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x multiplied by standard deviation of y. This is given to you in equation 31 of your book. So we need in the denominator, we need to have the standard deviation of x and the standard deviation of y. That is simple to do because earlier in chapter 3, you learned how to compute standard deviation. You take for each variable, for example, for x's, you take each x value and subtract from it the mean and square it. You add up all those square differences and you divide by n minus 1. Let's do that here. Notice the x minus x bar column has already been computed. In order to compute standard deviation for x, we need to square those differences in this column. Notice that we're squaring the values. So negative 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, and so on down the line. We get negative 3 squared is 9, 1 squared is 1, and 1 squared is 1. And then we need to sum it up, which is 16. We will use that in computing standard deviation for x, which is 16 divided by n minus 1, which is 4. So I'm sorry, that's not standard deviation, that is variance. That is variance. Then we take square root of the variance to get standard deviation. So coming down here again, the 16 divided by 4, which is 4, is variance. Therefore, standard deviation of x is square root of 4, which is 2. Same thing we want to do to compute the standard devi I'm sorry, the variance, sample variance for y. So notice that y minus y bar column was already computed in order to compute covariance. All I need to do is square that column. So negative 2 squared is 4, neg 3 squared is 9, one, negative 1 squared is 1, this one is 1, and this one is 1. If you add it up, you also get 16. It doesn't have to be that these two numbers equal each other. In this problem, it just so happens. So we have 16 divided by n minus 1. We had 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 y values. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So we get 4, and therefore, and that's the variance for y. These are the variances. These are variances. And these are our standard deviations. So the standard deviation for y is square root of 4, square root of this 4 right here, which happens to be 2. So, and the, oops, these numbers right here are the squared values of these numbers right here. All right, so we have in order to compute standard the correlation coefficient, we take the covariance, which we computed to be 2.75, and we divide by it the product of standard deviation of x and standard deviation of y. So 2.75 divided by 4, which happens to be 0.6875. I will show you in the next video using Excel that the sample correlation coefficient for this data set is 0.6875. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you.